the portion of Noach. Noach is one of the most interesting of all the personalities of the Bible, and also a personality which it is difficult to define. The Bible opens, Noach ish tzaddik. Noach was a righteous person. Tamim haya bedorotav, wholehearted in his generations. Now he spanned a very long life, many generations. And that's the simple interpretation of wholehearted in his generations. But there are some who pick up in it, some who pick up on the word positively. If in his generation, which was so wicked, he was righteous, had he been in a generation of righteous people, he would have been much more righteous even. And there are those who see it negatively. Only for his generation, and in comparison with the wicked of his generation, was he righteous. Had he been in the generation of an Abraham, he wouldn't have been accounted for anything. That's what Rashi says. And the question is, just about everything that we hear about Noah in the Bible is positive. Except for the fact that he got drunk, that's a different story. And we'll come to it perhaps next year. Please God. But why even imagine that he would have been less righteous had he lived in the generation of an Abraham? And the Morale of Prague puts it very, very well when he says that both Noah and Abraham had to confront the same kind of situation. God tells Abraham that he's going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, the wicked of Sodom and Gomorrah. And God tells Noah he's going to destroy the world because of the wickedness that has filled the world. And Abraham argues mightily on behalf of Sodom and Gomorrah. Noah doesn't argue at all. He builds an ark. Because of this, because he seemed to be only concerned with himself and his family and didn't even argue on behalf of the world, Noah, had he lived in the generation of Abraham, wouldn't have been accounted for anything. There's another view. And the other view is that it took Noah 120 years to build the ark. Why did it take him so long? And the answer given by that view is Noah was trying to convince everyone to repent. And then the world would not have been destroyed. Now there's another place in which we see the two divergent opinions. In Genesis chapter 6, verse 16, the text reads, Tzohar ta'aseh la'teva. God tells Noah to construct a tzohar, a light, for the ark. And the Midrash has two views as to what this light was, how this light functioned. Yesh omrim chalom, there are those who say it was a window. V'yesh omrim even tova shemi'ir alehem, it was a very precious stone that gave off light for them. Was it a window, or was it a chandelier in our language? Now, what's the difference between a window and a chandelier? A chandelier gives light for the people inside. A window not only provides light for the people inside, but it enables the people inside to see the people outside and to see the suffering of the people outside. Whether Noah was righteous only for his generation or would have been righteous in any generation depends upon whether Noah really cared about the rest of the world or not. And the view that says he was righteous in all generations is because he really did care and he tried to get the world to repent. And that's the view that would say that the light was a window, because Noah did look out and he was sensitive about the suffering of the people round about who didn't get to get into the ark. Those who believe that Noah was not sensitive, the light was a chandelier. He only cared about himself and his family and the people who were in the ark and the animals who were in the ark. He wasn't even interested in looking out. He only looked in. At the end of the day, perhaps Noah's drunkenness demonstrates that he was really only concerned with himself, and not even in the way in which his actions would impinge on other people. Be that as it may, there are two ways to look at Noah, but there's only one way to look at the Jewish ideal and the Jewish vision. And the Jewish vision is that we must always reach out and try to bring Torah and contentment to every single Jew and even to every human being. Shabbat Shalom.